So I've got a Nikon 5.8cm f1.4 that I was able to convert to work on my D750, but it'll work on any of the current and probably future Nikon digital cameras. And I did that by making a notch in the aperture ring. The conversion process is pretty easy. The first step is to remove the aperture ring, and it's held on by one screw. To make putting the aperture ring back on easier, I would suggest opening the lens all the way up to f1.4 so you have a nice reference point for the screw when you want to go put it back in. So I'm going to remove that screw and unscrew the aperture ring. I like to remove the pin follower, tab, prong, or whatever you want to call it, from all the lenses that I convert. Sometimes it will stick out into where you need to notch the aperture ring. I suppose you could leave it on and also grind it out, but I just also don't want something sticking out and being able to catch and snag on things. So I remove them, label them, and you can store them. And if you ever want to use a film camera, you'll have it. I've got the screw out and it's really small. I don't want to lose it. So I'm going to put it in a Dixie cup. If you lose the screw, it's going to be tough to use the lens. So be careful not to lose that. The aperture ring comes off really easily. You just unscrew it. There's a little dried grease in there that I'm going to eventually tear down the lens and re-grease everything, make it nice again. And you can hear the little clicks that the aperture ring makes, and the aperture ring's off. Didn't even have to remove the rear element cover. So to notch out the aperture ring so that it won't hit the follower tab and ruin the mount on your camera, I just used a Dremel with a coarse sanding bit or whatever. Came in at a perpendicular angle, so I get a nice square side right there where it rests against that little follower pin. Came back and just grind it away. It'll take something like 10-15 minutes maybe. Once I was done grinding, I came back with a old rusty file and just kind of smoothed it out a little bit to give it a slightly nicer finish. The most important part of the process is to get this notch lined up correctly. Mine's off by a little bit. I would suggest going from the 8 side of the screw hole for the pin follower that was removed earlier. For the end of the notch, I just went a full quarter of the aperture ring, and that way I just didn't have to worry about this hitting the pin when the lens is being mounted or removed. After you're finished grinding, I suggest washing the aperture ring off in soap and water to remove all the metal bits that are there. Also going to probably remove a lot of the grease that's on the threads. Can re-grease it with a small amount of white lithium grease. I'm in the process of ordering some helicoid grease, so I will use that. And I'm also going to disassemble the lens and re-grease everything, so I'm going to wait for that to come before I do this. To get the aperture ring back onto the lens, there's a couple things you can do to make it easier. The first is that the threads are very fine, and you don't want to cross-thread the aperture ring and ruin everything. So when you go to put it on, I suggest rotating it counterclockwise, and there'll be, a slight click or drop in the threads when it's seated correctly, and then can be able to screw it on without fear of any cross-threading. So as it goes, you can hear the little clicks from the aperture. Eventually get to the point where it's screwed all the way in. And so here we have the aperture indicator. So we want to unscrew the lens so it's back to showing 1.4. Then, because that's not going to leave enough lip material on the aperture ring, unscrew it another full rotation back to the 1.4, and that will have enough material sticking out to where the aperture tab will catch and it will be able to follow it. Now it's time to put the screw back into the aperture ring. And if this is done incorrectly, because it has to go in this little slot, you're not going to be able to turn the aperture ring. So what I've found is that if you just go, you know, one rotation of the screw, work the aperture ring back and forth, another rotation, move the aperture back and forth, and just do that until the screw is all the way in, the motion back and forth will get it to seat correctly in that little slot, and you won't have to constantly take the screw out and put it back in or back it out and try to readjust it. Just taking a little time on the assembly and it'll fit in there just fine. It's in there, perfect. Now that the lens is reassembled, I think it's important to test it out on a inexpensive camera. I keep a Nikon EM around just for test purposes. It's a $20 maybe body. You can probably get them really cheap if they're broken. But we just want to make sure we're not ramming the tab right there. So I'm going to go ahead and mount it. I know that it's going to fit already. And a couple points. So this is when it's just down in the mount and there's a large gap between the tab and the end of the notch. So when I stick it down, I don't have to worry about this edge putting any pressure on the tab. And then when I turn it to go over, it locks into place. You can see there's a small gap there where I messed up. I do get correct exif data, but it could be a little better. So once it's in there and mounted, the way I figured to make sure that you're not gonna damage anything is to take a piece of paper and we're gonna use it as a feeler gauge. And you should be able to get a piece of paper in between the tab and the body of the lens, the aperture ring, just to make sure it's not rubbing anywhere, and put that through the entire range of motion on the aperture ring to make sure nothing is catching. If there's any rubbing or pressure when you're adjusting the aperture ring or when you've gone to mount it or remove it from the camera, you're gonna have to remove the aperture ring again, grind down more material, and then try it again. It took me 3 attempts. I was fairly conservative in the grinding that I was doing. I wanted to remove as little material as possible and get a nice fit so that I could get the exif data. So just keep that in mind when you're going through. You know, patience pays off. And here's the end result. The lens mounts to the camera, no problem. I'm able to control the aperture. No rubbing, no issues anywhere. So quite happy with how it turned out. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this helpful. At some point in the future, I'll have a review out on the lens, and then in a few months, I plan to completely disassemble it and regrease, clean all the elements, things like that. So if you'd like to see either of those, make sure to hit subscribe.